Hey, I'm back for game two on the play against Green Devotion. And this hand's not perfect, but it has a couple of answers to Polukrinos. And if I do draw a couple lands in a row, I'll be able to play a couple masters. Even just one land will help me scry into the next land. So that's good. Let's see if the opponent has another Burning Tree draw. Hopefully not. Alright, just looks like nothing, which I'm definitely a fan of. And because I have the Rapid, I can afford to tap out for Master next turn with no fear of Polukrinos. I'll probably just dissolve whatever is cast here. I'm not going to dissolve Burning Tree. That doesn't really do too much. Especially since my master has protection from red. Alright, and nothing else. I'm okay with that. Tidebinder is good. I think I want to just play a Master Waves this turn, use all of my mana. And then maybe next turn I can cast Tidebinder and have Dissolve up. Okay, Polukrinos. Okay, I think the best play is to cast another Master. And then I can attack in whichever creature is blocked by Polukrinos. I can rapid it. I can rapid the Polukrinos after. Or I could just rapid the Polukrinos and then attack with only the elementals. Alright, I think it's better to cast the Master first and just rapid after. I think this way I'm guaranteed. Or at least I'm more likely to get in more damage. If my opponent doesn't have Setessan Tactics, I should be in pretty great shape. Even if my opponent does, I think I'm still in good shape. All right, I was able to win that game pretty swiftly. I think on the draw, dissolve could be quite worse than it is on the play. So I'm going to cut one dissolve for one dispel. It may seem odd to bring in dispel against a mono green deck, but I think Setessan Tactics is one of the cards to be most afraid of. So I'll submit this for game three.